Hey, what's going on, everybody? Jake here with Venture Visuals, and today I am hyped because we are going to be breaking down how to use cinematic titles on your music videos to give it a unique style. More and more in today's music videos, I'm seeing people use very unique graphic design to come up with their own creative titles and title animations in their music video edits. So I thought today's tutorial would be perfect because we're going to be breaking down how you can create your own cinematic titles and use them over your own music videos, and how you can use my Photoshop title template pack available for download on venturevisuals.com. So if you're excited about learning how to create and use cinematic titles over your own music video footage, hit the like button down below and let's get into the tutorial. On my website, venturevisuals.com, we can come up here to shop and click on cinematic titles. And this is gonna be the entire cinematic title pack, which already has a bunch of title templates included. And we're gonna be talking about how you can use this pack today, how you can try it for free, and how you can customize these titles to fit the vibe of whatever music video that you're working on. So if I scroll back up to the top here under shop, if I click on free pack, and on this free pack page, if you come down to where it says email, we can actually just put in our email address right here at gmail.com. I recommend doing this on Google Chrome, and then we're just gonna hit submit right here. And once you submit your email, it's gonna open up with the free pack right here, where you can download any of the assets from my packs. You can click on cinematic titles, and then it's gonna open up with our free title template right here and a walkthrough guide as well. All we have to do is hit this download arrow on this free title template, and then it will download to our computer where we can open it up in Photoshop. If you do decide to download the entire pack, you're gonna get a folder that looks like this with 25 different title templates already ready to go, with different fonts, different design elements already included in the pack. It's just a really great starting point. I've been using them a lot for the music videos that I've been editing. It also comes with an icon sheet right here where you can take any of these elements and apply them to your own cinematic titles to get even more unique look. For today's example, we're gonna be throwing a cinematic title over top of some very vintage looking hip hop music video footage. Let's just take a look at the very first 15 to 20 seconds of this music video so we can start to get a vibe.
That was more than a vacation down to Californication. Now I'm headed home like it's overloaded bases.
One clip that I noticed stood out to me was this clip right here. There's just not a lot of detail. So what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna come to my title pack, and I'm just gonna find a title that I think is gonna look appropriate for this intro. This one's kind of cool. This one's pretty cinematic. I also really like this one, number 8. This one's really cool as well. And honestly, our free template that's included in the free pack might be the best fit for this video. So let's actually take the free template and go ahead and open it in Photoshop. Come over here to my layers, and you can see if we hide each of these layers, what each of them holds. So we have our main text, our top and bottom, our crosses, and our sides. So from here, we can maybe turn off the side just in case we don't want these elements on the side of our screen, and we can just leave it like this. And then what I can do is open up this main text folder right here, and I can begin to change the text to whatever the music video is that we're working on. So I'm just gonna click on the word cinematic over here. I'm gonna make sure that I have my text tool selected. I'm gonna double click on the word cinematic, and I'm gonna change it to say awesome, which is the name of this music video that we're editing. Another really cool thing about this title pack, and if you own the Adobe Photoshop software, what you can do is highlight the text, come up here under your text options, and then if you own the Photoshop software, like I said, you'll have this more from Adobe fonts button right here. And this is where you can download 100 plus different types of font kits that you can use on your own cinematic titles. So say you really like the layout of this template, but you want to change the font up. What we can do is either take a default font already installed in Photoshop, or we can come up here to more from Adobe fonts, select this button, and that's going to open up our Adobe Fonts web browser. And in this web browser, we can actually find a bunch of different text kits, and you can find some really, really dope fonts on here that are really cool for music videos. But that's just another reason why I've included 25 templates here in the cinematic titles pack. I didn't want to just include, you know, one specific style of font, so we get a nice variety of different fonts in this pack. I really like this one. This one's really cool. This one's really cool. So now that I've changed the main text here, I'm actually going to change some of these other details. So directed and edited by Venture Visuals. We can say directed by Popcorn LA, which is who shot the video. And maybe we change this to the name of the artist. So we can just say P. Washington right there, which is the name of the artist. Obviously, this doesn't look centered right now, but we can, you know, fix that later on. And then under Titles Pack Volume 1, let's change this to Summer of 2022. Command click all of these text layers right here, and then I'm going to come up here under my Align Tools, and I'm just going to make sure everything is aligned in the center. And now what I'm going to do is save this to my desktop. So let's hit File. Let's hit Save As. Let's hit Save on your computer. And on my desktop, we're going to save this as Awesome Title Template. So now what we're going to do is import this into After Effects and throw on some animation. So I'm going to open After Effects, and then all I have to do is click and drag the title template we've just created into my composition. Make sure that you have editable layer styles turned on, because we're going to want to animate our layers independently. So we're going to hit OK. So from here, I can double click on this composition, and that's going to open up our individual layers where we can do our individual animating if we want to. Let's animate the top and bottom borders to, you know, maybe kind of expand out as the title displays. So let's go ahead and select our top and bottom borders right here. I'm going to hit S. This is going to change our scale, right? But we only want to change the horizontal scale. So I'm going to unlink our chain right there, and I'm going to make a keyframe where the value is 100. I'm going to drag it out to about 8 seconds. And then here in the beginning, I'm going to bring that value in. So it starts really, really skinny. Let's not start at zero. Let's start like right there. So you can see the top and bottom borders are now going to kind of animate out with this title. And then what I like to do with cinematic visuals is just add a little bit of a flicker effect to the text to make it look a little bit more real. So with my main text layer selected, I'm just going to hit T. That's going to open up our opacity values. I'm just going to come every couple of frames and change the opacity down, maybe back up a little bit. Let's go down a little farther, go a couple frames over. We'll stay at this value for a little while. So once I get to about a second here of keyframes, what I can do is highlight all my keyframes, copy them, paste them across our timeline here until we get to about 6 seconds worth. And now as I play this back, you'll see that we get this kind of like flickering text effect that's happening. Now that I've done some animating of this title template, what I can do is turn off this bottom layer, that's this black layer, so we get this transparent background. If you don't see the transparent background, just toggle your transparency grid right here, and it should pop up for you. Now I'm gonna drag my out point in to about a little bit over 6 seconds. So we're only rendering 6 seconds worth of this title. And then I'm gonna come up here to composition. I'm gonna add to render queue. And this is an important step because we want our background to remain transparent when we import this into Premiere. So what we need to do is change our output module. Click on that little drop down arrow and hit lossless with alpha. And then we can change our output name. We can just say awesome title template, that's fine, save it to our desktop and hit render. Once it's done rendering, all we need to do is hop back here into Premiere Pro and figure out what clip we want our title to appear. So for me, it's going to be this clip where there's not a whole lot of detail, everything's kind of out of focus, and I think this is going to be perfect to put a title on top of. So what I'm going to do from here, find where I rendered my title out to. So I rendered it out on my desktop. And I'm just going to place that onto my Premiere Pro timeline. It's going to appear large like this because our sequence here is in 1920 by 1080. It was not shot in 4K, but these title templates are all designed in 4K. So what we need to do is just decrease the size by coming up here to scale and changing it from 100 to 50. And that's going to put it accurately in the middle of our screen. And now what I can do is just shorten it up to however long we want it to be. We can shorten it up there in the beginning. So we want it to line up with this cut. boom. So let's go ahead and check out what this looks like over top of our footage with our little flicker animation.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think that looks really, really cool. I think one thing I want to do is actually have this like kind of zooming in a little bit too. So what I can do is just make a keyframe under my scale with this title. Let's go up to like 53 or so. So it just gradually kind of zooms in. So you might want to get rid of these top and bottom bars. And if you've already animated and you don't want to go back into After Effects and get rid of these bars or get rid of these sides right here, all you can do is click on this title template. Let's just go to an effect called Crop. And we're just going to crop this title template in a little bit. So let's crop the top and let's take that value up. So boom, it's all removed there at the top. Let's take it up a little bit at the bottom. So now we're just left with this middle title right here, which to some of you guys might look a little bit cleaner. I like it. It looks cool to me. So let's render this out. Let's see how this looks like.
Yeah. Yeah.
I absolutely love how this is looking. So again, guys, the titles pack is on my website. If you want to check it out, you can also download the same template we used today for free. It's included in the free pack, which I'll include a direct link to in the description below if that sounds interesting to you. Designing titles for music videos is one of the most enjoyable parts of the process, I think, for me personally, just having a little bit of that graphic design involvement in the overall look and feel of the video is really, really cool. If any of you out there have questions or comments about the cinematic titles pack or how to design your own cinematic titles, please comment down below and let me know. I try to respond to everybody who comments on this channel, and I really appreciate those of you who have been subscribing, liking, and commenting on my videos. This community continues to grow more and more every day, and I could not be more excited for what the future holds for all of us. Now, like I said before, if you're looking to add some sauce to your edits today, definitely check out my website, ventervisuals.com. My free pack includes samples from every other pack on the site where you can try everything out for free. You can learn how to use each pack individually without spending any money at all. So if that sounds interesting to you, definitely check out my links down below. And feel free to comment below any types of tutorials that you might want to see me create. And until next time, guys, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.